Okay. Hi. Today I wanted to talk briefly about using the Disting MK4 as a pitch and envelope follower. This question originally came from Tom Evans on the DivKit Patreon Discord. He was asking if any of us had any experience with this mode and could share our results. Since I had never actually used it before, and since I often interface my guitar or bass with the modular, I figured this would be a worthy experiment and decided to do a quick video to document it. I'm not going to get into patch ideas here, just the basic functions and their results. It turned out to be pretty fun though, so I may explore some patches in future videos. So let's start by taking a look at the functionality and then the setup. In this mode, the X input on the Disting is the line input. The manual does not list functionality for the Y input, so unless there is something undocumented, I'm going to assume it does not have one. Output A is volt per octave pitch CV based on the incoming audio signal. According to the manual, 0 volts is set to be C3, or approximately 130.81 Hz. Attempting to tune the oscillator to C3 with 0 volts on the pitch input, however, led to some bizarre scaling issues, and I found the results to be much better if I simply tuned the oscillator to match the guitar based on a note in the middle of the range. Output B is the envelope of the signal at input X. When no pitch is detected, this falls to 0. This envelope has variable slew via the Z knob and CV input. In my tests, I basically dialed in the sweet spot for this based on my input source and did not vary or modulate it. So with that in mind, let's now look at the setup. First, I'm running my guitar to the line in on my shared system by Make Noise. This is specifically to have a way to increase the gain of the incoming signal. Otherwise, as I found, the envelope output by the Disting won't really have enough dynamic range to be useful without modification. Again though, this will vary dependent upon your input source and may not be necessary in your situation. From there, I mount the signal to two separate locations. The first of these goes to the mixer so that we can hear the incoming audio. There's a bit of delay applied via a send to the Lyra effects. Let's take a moment to hear what this sounds like. Actually though, I usually play with my fingertips, so to emulate a more common scenario, let's use a pick. That'll sound like this. Okay, whatever. So back to the setup. From the mult, the other guitar signal goes to channel 1 of data. That's the green trace up top. Apologies for the soft focus on that shot. Hopefully you can still get the idea. From there, it heads to the X input on Disting. The A output, or pitch CV, heads to channel 2 on data, which is the blue trace. And from there to the pitch CV input of oscillator 1 on the clavis twin waves, set to the saw try algorithm. The B output, or envelope, is connected to channel 3 on data, which is the red trace, and from there it is controlling the level of my VCA. This then runs dry to the mixer. I've already dialed in a sweet spot for the slew on the envelope follower that keeps as much noise or atonal information out of the audio as possible. So let's listen to the dry oscillator signal controlled by the guitar being played with a pick. As you can hear, it's a little weird. It really only manages to grab tones at the higher registers. It seems that the percussive element of the pick throws off the tracking substantially. So what if I generated a smoother tone by playing the guitar with my thumb, Wes Montgomery style? As it turns out, this almost entirely solves the issue and leads to very stable tracking. In the demos for this feature, Oz uses a clarinet sample to demonstrate. In other words, a very simple, continuous tone without many overtones or harmonics. Based on the results here, I think I see why. That said, this atonality can actually be used to interesting effect. Let's blend the oscillator and the guitar signals and play around a little. While I can't say much for my playing here, the overall effect is pretty interesting. Varying the playing technique in other ways seems to also lend interesting results. Palm muting, for instance, also improves the quality of the tracking. Here's an example. So hopefully this short video has been helpful and has given you a few ideas on how you might utilize this mode for the Disting. I may follow up with some patch ideas. This was really just intended as a video response to a forum question, essentially. So make note in the comments if you would like to see follow-up videos. And be sure to subscribe to this channel if you liked the content, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.